Mr. Bloem, a very good morning to you.
Good morning, Blaine, and good morning to the viewers as well.
Look, our deepest condolences goes out to you as well as the friends and family of Mluleki George. Tell us a bit more with regards to the circumstances surrounding his death.
Blaine, I must say that it is a very sad day for us that this comrade Mluleki George has passed on. We got this messages last night, and we were not sure about this messages, because you know what is happening in today's life, this fake news that is going on all over. Now, this morning we confirmed with several of our people in the Eastern Cape. It's very sad. We will say that this is a very, very massive loss to not only to his family, but to the entire country. The role that Comrade George have played in our liberation struggle, nobody can question that. Because Comrade George was in the forefront in dismantling apartheid in sport. He was known for that. Comrade George was a founder member of the United Democratic Front, the UDF, in 1983, when apartheid was very, very, very strong at that time. Comrade George put his life on stake and said he is going to do that. Comrade George spent time on Robben Island as a freedom fighter. In 2008, Comrade George and some of us went to the Pulukwani conference of the ANC and told the comrades there. Comrade George was in the forefront in saying to the comrades, please don't elect Jacob Zuma as the leader of the ANC, because this country, he will destroy the ANC and he will destroy the country as a whole. People didn't want to listen to the advice of Comrade George, a voice, a very strong voice against corruption. Now, today we can see what Comrade George has preached and predicted. Now, we, as the Congress of the People, are saying that we are very saddened, and we want to pass our heartfelt condolences to his family, his friends, his comrades, and everybody who was close to Comrade George.
You say that the country has lost another patriot who loved his country. You touched on his role in sport in this country, his role within the National Sports Council back in the 80s. I want to talk a bit more about that, Mr. Bloem. Tell us more about that pivotal role he played in sport.
You know, when apartheid was a black and white sport, Comrade George put his head with the late Comrade Steve Tred. Comrade George made contact with the ANC outside, with people like Comrade Steve Tred. And they, together with Comrade Tred, brought sports bodies together, black and white. Comrade George was not just a talker. Comrade George was a doer. When he was saying that he's going to do a thing, he's going, and the results are there. There was no black and white sports. Black people could not play with white people. The contribution of Comrade George, today we can see we are having sports, Olympics, and everything. We were banned from international sports, but the contribution of Comrade George made it possible that young athletes today can compete all over the world because of the contribution of Comrade George.
Mr. Bloem, when was the last time you spoke to Mr. George?
Well, it was I think last month. Last month in November was the last time I spoke to Comrade George. And he was He was, I must tell you that he was very disillusioned in the turn that the country took. Well, he was talking all the time to me about that, that all the efforts, all the struggles that we have put in is going to the dogs. That was, it was, I can say without any doubt that Comrade George died with a painful heart.
Why was he so disillusioned? What was on top of his list in order to rectify within this country? What do you think?
Well, the level of corruption, and not only that, but his beloved party, his movement, the ANC, what we see, what Comrade George was always talking about, this glorious movement has become, when President Cyril Ramaphosa said that the ANC is the number one in the dock of corruption, Comrade George, we spoke about it. That pains him very, very, very badly. That today we must hear that the ANC, his beloved party, must be labeled as the number one corrupt party in the dock. It pains him very, very badly.
Behind the persona, behind the politician, who was Mluleki George?
Comrade Mluleki George was a person not only in politics, but he was also a devoted member, a staunch member, and a leader in the Methodist Church. Mm. He believed in God. That man was always, when we open meetings, Comrade George have said to us, we cannot open a meeting without a prayer. That was Comrade George. He was a very kind person, very soft, very active a person, energetic to see the people of South Africa free. He was a very good-hearted person.
You know, you have no doubt had many interactions with him, not only on the political stage, but also on a personal level. Mr. Bloem, what would you miss the most?
Sorry?
What would you miss the most?
I will miss his jokes. Comrade George was a very jokey person. I was with him in the UDF, with him in the ANC, when the ANC was unbanned, and then to quote, all the time when George was talking to me, there will be jokes. All the time, he did not want to see people sad. Even through all these problems of the Congress of the People, George was always a person who was full of jokes. He wanted us to smile and not to be sad. I will miss the jokes of Comrade George every day.
And, you know, my only wish is that, to take forward what you said, when you think about him and his legacy, may a smile come to your lips before a tear comes to your eyes. Sir, once again, our deepest condolences to you and the George family. Be well.
Thank you very much. And we must say, as the Congress of the People, to the family, the comrades, may his soul rest in peace.
Dennis Bloem, COPE National Spokesperson there.